Well, throw me a pokeball and call me Slowpoke. I had this whole joke planned where I'd call our glorious leader, many miles away, a nerd, because he is more focused on school rather than unicorn reviews because of the lack of new videos on his channel up until recently. Then he posts a review of the KMS Emden as I'm writing this. Thanks for ruining my joke at your expense, you nerd. Anyway, let's get this show on the road.
No, God! No, God, please, no! No! No!
The burning you feel? It is shame.
No!
Oh, booger, the tank is on fire.
That didn't hurt. Look at you! You look like you ran through traffic!
Welcome to my new series, The Wannabe Unicorn Review, where I copy Miles' format, who himself copied Slow Phantom's format for that game that shall not be named. Before we get started, I want to give a special thanks to Stux Sucks and Master Absolute for helping me film the skit you just watched. Now on with the review. The T-20 is a premium 5.0 medium tank that costs about 3,000 golden chickens. Free a boost with a credit card by this tank, hoping that money will solve all of their problems, like a true capitalist. They do this when they get sick of the 500 different Shimans in tiers 2 and 3, as well as their 75mm potato launchers, and want to actually be able to kill something without being forced to play dodgeball on expert mode in the M18 Hellcat. This speedy boy is an early prototype of what would eventually become the M26 Pershing, and features a rear-end transmission, which eliminates the need of the drive shaft that made the M4 Shimans as tall as the Empire State Building. It also has the same 76mm gun as the M18 Hellcat, allowing you to easily ruin the days of Werabus and commie sympathizers who think they are invincible for bouncing 75mm potatoes all day. Speaking of the M18 Hellcat, the T20 is pretty much one, but with some actual gosh darn armor, so you won't be vaporized if anyone happens to fart in your general direction. In fact, the front plate is 76.2 millimeters thick, angled back 47 degrees, presenting the enemy with over 100 millimeters of effective protection. That's roughly 10 more millimeters than what you get on most shipments. The side armor for the crew compartment is also thicker at 50.8 millimeters, while the engine only gets the standard 38.1. The turret is 63.5 millimeters thick, with the gun mantlet being 88 millimeters. This gives you more overall protection than any Shimon except for the Jumbo and M6 heavy tank. However, you should not rely on it to protect your lazy American buttocks, as the Germans, Russians, and French all have at least two guns that can easily dab on your turret and side armor at a 45 degree angle from 500 meters away, if not straight through the front plate. But it is still good enough to make T-34/85 players' hearts skip a beat when they don't immediately headbutt you back to the Great Depression. The T-20 is lighter than any Shimon at 29.8 tons, but also has a more powerful engine with 500 Mustangs. This allows the tank to free nations at a theoretical top speed of 35 miles per hour, or 56 kilometers per hour for you metric peasants, but realistically, you will be rolling across the battlefield at 20 miles per hour or 32 kilometers per hour on flat terrain, or about as fast as you can go on Interstate 5 on a weekday. But that's not all. This baby can reverse up to a lovely 11 miles per hour, and it can turn almost as quickly as the Hellcat can. This makes the T2×10 one of the most mobile medium tanks in Tier 3, giving Stalin's swarm of T-34s a run for their money. Keeping up with trash 85s is all well and good, but you need a powerful enough gun to finish off those pesky Reds and their fascist frenemies. Luckily, the Tango 20 has the same M1, 76mm Big Mac launcher found on the M18, with the standard 10 degrees of gun depression found on all American tanks, allowing you to fire over moderate inclines without exposing your whole vehicle. The reloading rate is a decent 7.65 seconds, which can be brought down to 6 seconds with an ace screw. For ammunition, you get the M62A PCBC Big Mac shell with 116 mm of penetration against flat armor at 500 meters. It also has 65 grams of explosive filler, which gives your enemies a spicy surprise immediately after the significant emotional event you just gave them. You also get the M79AP Solid Mac double shell with 131 mm of penetration, which is good for dealing with long-range targets. HE is completely worthless. In addition to the Big Mac cannon, you are also provided with a 7.62 mm machine gun mounted in the hull and a topside 50 caliber French fry dispenser for dealing with the enemy's cancerous air support and cheeky reserve tanks. Now here's how you play the 20T posers. Load 20 rounds of both M62 and M79, while telling HE to go commit river. I mentioned earlier that this is an M18 with armor, so you can use it in a similar fashion. You use your speed and maneuverability to move around the enemy and hit him where he doesn't expect it, going for side and rear shots. I call this tactic flanking and spanking, and it works especially well on teams full of half-blind idiots with no situational awareness. The other method you can utilize is similar to that of the Sardine Can 85, where you take the role of a brawler and get in up close and personal, again using your mobility to pop out of cover and immediately pull back to bait foes into firing and missing, at which point you pop out again to show them the spirit of 76, aiming for cannon breaches and engines of vehicles that you can't frontally penetrate, like the BIOS 1 and BIOS 2. Commander's cupolas are perfect shot traps for your APCBC rounds, especially on the BIOS tanks, where the crew would be instantly purged in a rain of holy fire and shrapnel.
Purge it in flames!
What the screaming eagles was that? Good grief, I can literally hear my heartbeat now. Anyway, Panthers can be crippled by hitting the lower left or right corners of the turret. The rare French Errol 44 can be killed with the Panther tactic, but if you encounter a French Jumbo, try and hit the MG port or flank it like it's 1940 all over again. The vehicles you will have the most trouble with are the German Jagdpanzerlein, for the 38T, aim for the lower, right or left corners of the gun mantlet. For the Jagd Panzer IV, aim just above or below the driver's viewport. You cannot effectively penetrate the Panzer IV over 70 anywhere from the front, so you have no choice but to flank, but you can try your luck with the RNG stick on the lower glasses, which protects the transmission. You damage that, and the sucker is immobilized. Many players will try to hit your cannon breech, which makes your mobility even more annoying for them when they miss due to your turret's small profile. If they go for hull shots, they sometimes don't lead the target far enough, miss the crew, and hit the engine, giving you a brief chance to return fire and repair. But that only happens if you get caught in the open. As a rule of thumb for all ground vehicles, stick to cover wherever you can. Densely foliated areas are good for concealment, but once the enemy knows you're there, run like hell. Since the T-20 is a premium vehicle and you are a pay-to-win scrub, you don't need to worry about modifications, as they are unlocked for you when you sell your soul to Gage Eagles. As for crew skills, focus on leadership, weapon reloading for more ammo, tank driving for the fast and furious, then targeting and range finding for more 360 quickscopes. Field repair is highly recommended, as you will be fixing your tank 40 to 50% of the time. Finally, finish off the remaining skills. After that, do whatever you please. Before we wrap this up, let's review. The T-20 is a fast, decently armored medium tank with an excellent gun that gives you plenty of flexibility in combat, provided you have a credit card and $20 to burn. Whether you prefer to flank and spank, or brawl with the best of them, use your high mobility to bait the enemy and dodge their shots, so you can spread freedom and democracy with ease. That's everything you need to know about the T-20. Now get out there and show them the power of capitalism.